We'll build my gallows and build them high. Makes a long time climbing before I die. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Short Bangers. I'm Matty.
Hello, I'm Colin.
Hello, I am backtracking Rishi Sunak.
That sounds like a euphemism for something that you didn't like something that's in the Urban Dictionary. What you've been doing? I've been doing some backtracking, and if everyone's trying to work out what does he mean by backtracking, what's that? It sounds like it involves like the wrong hole for a start.
I saw a mug on a video during the week there, and it was a woman that was saying, "I always thought that my mug said Busty Pelican." And she was having a wee giggle about it, and then she had a look at it a wee bit closer, it said Rusty Pelican. I thought, oh, what's the significance of this? It's an Urban Dictionary classic, so you should look it up.
A Rusty Pelican.
A Rusty Pelican, aye. Naturally, it's a sexual act.
My daughters were kept saying the word segs the other day, like, as if they were being clever about it, but on apparently TikTok, if you have the word sex, the algorithm bans it or whatever, so that they have subtitles where somebody's meaning the word sex, it writes the word segs, like eggs with an S on the front.
That's so clever.
What a waste of time that is, eh?
Like, by the way, that's terrible, that Rusty Pelican.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. It's not something I've ever participated in myself.
No, right. It's pretty fucking... Pretty poor, pretty poor show. Anyway,
I feel like I have to look it up now. So,
what's the audio equivalent of clickbait? Because I think Colin just nailed it. Everyone's now Googling this. What's a Rusty Pelican?
Stopping the cars and that.
You won't believe what this looks like.
You won't believe somebody came up with this. Oh, yeah. Just leave that there.
There was maybe a second and a half there, Matty, where your eyebrows just went up and then up.
Right, Venti's Plenty has got the first question. Oh, I forgot to ask you, do you want some questions?
No.
Nope.
John?
Okay. No.
Well, you're getting a question anyway, right, whether you like it or not.
Is that John's background? That's
no use. I was John's. I don't know what it was, but I was tempted to answer.
Yeah. Your wife is in her mother having a right party.
It was a telly or something, wasn't it?
Oh, sorry. Is that the first time it's come through?
You're all right. It was inaudible. Like, you would need sort of like Jack Bauer levels audio decoding techniques.
I just heard John's a cunt. That was all I heard him say.
Well, I don't know what like order that was over there as well. Right, Venti's Plenty said. Right, we've got two questions from him. There's two part, all right. Topic is Awooga. Can you guess what's coming next?
It's Gladiators related. John Fashion related.
Mm. Well, whatever happened.
Oh, no, was it Chris Akabusi that had that catchphrase?
No.
Fashion, I'm sure.
And what was Vic Reeves done? Ufavu.
Ufavu, yeah, and Aranu. Which I will so occasionally. Just tap on my daughter's door and open it and just go Iranu with that. And that's what I'm talking about, thankfully. Like, it's totally weird. Right, whatever happened to the big foam fingers that were all over the crowd at Gladiators and briefly during other sporting events in the early 90s? And also, was it weird at the time to have the Gladiators measurements when the Gladiator was announced? And they did do that as well. He's got like a GIF and it's Jet. So, height, 5'6", 9 stone, 6 pounds, 39-inch chest, 26-inch waist, and it's 35-inch hips. And the reason it took me a while there is because the GIF goes quick and it only does a bit at a time. So I couldn't keep up with it.
Mm.
That's a weird thing to do, isn't it? You wouldn't do that now, don't you think? That would be
you wouldn't, but you don't have PC3 anymore. And that's where PC3 used to do that, mate. Here's fucking Lucy, 16. Like, fucking measurements. Hi. You know what I mean? That was the... Because it was 16 to go on page 3, wasn't it? Like, Sam Fox was 16, I think. That's a famous one. Actually, countdown to her birthday. So she could get a tattoo for you. Yeah.
Deary me.
Mental.
It's mental. Right, so we're saying, yes, it was weird, right? But what happened to the big foam fingers? Did any of you think that there was people that just had big hands? Like, that typically went to...
Nah, I didn't think so. I think the Gladiators maybe had big hands, but they weren't doing the... What was the song? that they used to use for it. It was like a, it was a Queen song, wasn't it?
We Will Rock You, is it?
I was going to say We Will Rock You comes to mind.
No, it's another one, Makes It Dust.
Was it?
When somebody fell off the
aye.
The big sticks, the big,
the big cotton buds.
Aye, the big cotton bud things.
No, pugil sticks, they were called, I'm sure.
Aye, that's right.
What were they called? Pugil sticks.
Pugil sticks, oh, yeah.
Do you think there's going to be shite, yeah, Gladiators, a load of shite. That was another one that was immediately turned off in my house. If by that
it really? It was how'd you get it be shite then?
Because I didn't always watch telly at my house. Like, if you wanted to, if I wanted to watch stuff that was considered shite in my house, I would have to go to a pal's. Like, A Team Dukes. Well, Dukes of Hazzard was on it. I'm sorry to watch that. A Team definitely was in that. We've talked about this before.
Aye, we have, aye.
And the, like, the wrestling. Gladiators definitely came under that bracket. It was never on in my house. Like, it would have been fucking off unless my mum and dad put it and then you'd watch it.
So you were prevented from watching Gladiators? Is that
okay. Saturday tea time that was on, eh? Like,
aye. Like 5 o'clock prime time.
I was often playing rugby, so I used to not get home till after that.
Keep it and watch it later in your room.
Oh, I on my head just yet.
Aye.
But the aye, it was funny the boys put the 40 jet in as well out of them. Like,
no,
no reason for it. It's nuts, say that they'd done that. What did they do for the guys?
Well, they would have done
their chest size in that.
Aye, they would have all that because they were big bastards, weren't they? Like, so
does the chest measurement make more sense from a male point of view, or is it equally objectifying men and women contestants, or
I suppose at least it was equal opportunities.
Yeah, they do the men.
However, what difference does it make? Is anybody actually sitting there going, I don't think she's got a 26 waist, like, I think that's a 28. If ever I see one, I mean, like,
she's going to struggle in this event with that, with tooth in a waist.
The hips, you'll not get through that with the hips.
I'm trying to see if there's an equivalent. I can't remember all the name. Wolf is the one that I remember, and just trying to see if there's a gif.
Hunter.
Him with his.
I remember Shadow. Shadow was undefeated on the pugil sticks for a long time.
Was he the one that went to jail?
Aye, got done for drugs and all sorts.
Well, I can't see anything with Wolf's measurements on it. If anybody has a gift, let's send it in, tweet us, and we'll settle it once and for all. A weird thing to do. The big foam fingers, do they still exist in things? And can you still get them?
I think they're going to get found in the stomachs, like turtles and fish, and that's going to be the next environmental scandal.
Like the opposite of microplastic, because it was so big.
Yeah.
Okay. Right,
unless there's just like a portion of a rubbish tip somewhere that's just like foam, like thousands and thousands of foam fingers just flapping in the wind, just one finger.
Surely they could have cut them up and made them like stuffed mattresses and stuff with them if they'd. Maybe they recycled back then, eh? Like they wouldn't have occurred to them. They'll all be in landfill.
Chuck them in the fire.
Which will confuse archaeologists in fucking centuries' time, you know, when they're going digging and they're like, hey, we've got our old site here. It's fascinating that this looks like a landfill site. That's where people put their rubbish. And they go, look at these fucking gloves. But it's mental when they go, like, our ancient ancestors had one massive hand with a big finger. And that's what they'll think, and it'll be documented as well as when they find the phones and that, and they look and they'll say, and we've looked at the photos, and folk had bunny ears and fucking whiskers and bug noses and stuff like that. Well, the filters that folk put on.
Taking into account the amount of data that is generated and recorded nowadays, how many years do you think it'll be before archaeologists as a field, as a study, is just extinct? Like, it doesn't exist anymore because we just record everything that we do on an ongoing basis.
Well, so you didn't have to go looking for the evidence because it's all there.
So you were talking about like archaeologists coming back and looking at foam fingers and thinking, oh, they had giant hands back then, but they'll have gifts, a jet available to them. There'll be someone in the background with a foam finger.
Look at your standard woman back in the day. They had a 32-inch hips and a 26-inch waist.
It's all written down for the, that was a typical specimen. Aye, you could be onto something, John, there. Like, but you'd maybe want to evidence it rather than just photos, because photos could be manipulated and you need to verify it with something.
Well, the Bible. use that. That,
well,
that seems to have worked.
Somebody should have went back and verified that. That's, yeah. Anyway, right. Before we get started on that, Dog Welder asked, what cancelled TV show do you wish carried on?
Cancelled because of inappropriateness, or cancelled just because it ran its course?
Ran its course. I, let's take just one that used to be on that's no longer on.
Mm-hmm. My Name Is Errol.
Did you not get bored of that?
What was that, sorry?
Well, I asked you, did you not get bored? I watched it at the start and I liked it and it was good, and then it got boring quite quick. I was like, I think they've kind of exhausted most of the
I really
stuff.
Enjoyed the premise of it, and I think it ended abruptly in the fourth series. I'm not saying it needed to go on for an indefinite period of time. Like, one more series would have done it for me and I would have been satisfied. But they just left it in a total cliffhanger. I can't remember if someone went to jail, go out of jail or what, but they ended that too soon. The other one was a program called, oh, what was it? I forget what the name of it was, but hopefully someone out there that's listening remembers. There was the story was about a young guy who was very ill when he was a baby, and his mum and dad sold his soul to the devil in return for his good health. So the boy grew up and he was well and everything, and then the devil came and said, well, you work for me now. That was part of the trade. And it maybe run for about a series or two, and that was it. And again, it ended on a cliffhanger, because I think the guy was, the boy, he was playing the devil for his soul, and they were playing like I don't know what we would call it here, or if we even play it here. He was like
Mario
chipping
Kart
quarters into a shot glass.
Oh.
And the devil being the devil broke the boy's like shooting hand, and he's like, oh fuck, what am I going to do now? And that's where it left it. So they should have definitely continued that for another series or two.
Think you could have a pagger with the devil. So you're saying like he's broke it. Like, think you could just have a fist fight with the devil, assuming that it was real.
Is the assumption that he would always play dirty, or always like throw sand in your eyes or something, or put you in the boss?
I don't know. I'm just thinking that, like, if he's a physical being enough to be able to like play, chuck a coin in a cup, right, or Mario Kart, could you just have when? See, instead of playing this game, we would just have a punch up and then see if you could just take your chances that way. Because you couldn't be like the hardest person ever. Like, there's going to be somebody harder than him.
It would have put a different slant on Bill and Ted, because they played the devil. What did they play the devil for?
No, they played death, did they? No, they didn't play death.
Oh, death, sorry, death. That's true.
You seen Bill and Ted, Colin?
I think so. I think I have. I am pretty
excellent.
Sure.
Excellent.
Aye, so I have then, because I knew that I got the joke. Yeah.
Good.
TV programs, though. I'm racking my brains here, because I do like TV. Like, I watch more TV than I do films, as we've probably discovered on the years of this that I've been doing. But I get to a stage where you think, actually, you need to end this. Like, mm-hmm. you, the Americans, oh, this is a moneymaker. And it just goes on mm-hmm. and on and
aye.
On. And you're like, you need to end it. And then you can't, because you end up carrying on watching these things because you're kind of invested in it and you just want to see how it ends now. And I kind of think of many things that I've went, oh, they've ended that too soon. The Office, when it was on,
mm-hmm.
two series, and then they went to America and ripped arse with it. Now, yeah. It was a good American one as well, but, you know, like, it was fucking 40 series long or something. Right. And again, you're like, go and just get married in that. You know what I mean? Because it's like, you just want it to, like, you want to see what happens in the end, because it's been on that long. And that's where I am with loads of programs. I can't think of something. I suppose, like, The Sopranos, when it ended, spoiler alert, like, when it ended in 15, 20 years ago, and everybody went, is that the end? And you had to work it out yourself, sort of thing. And you could have done with an extra episode or 5 minutes an episode. That was deliberate. That was deliberate how they wanted it, to get folk talking and all that. But that was one where I really liked The Sopranos, and it ended like that, and you almost went, the fuck? Until you thought about it properly. Or Major Rain ending up. I can't get anything else that I've no wanted just to end, because they've went on for fucking ever.
Aye. Police Squad would have been good. Like, I think there was only a handful of episodes made of Police Squad, and that could have went fucking loads. Again, very quickly run out of jokes because it's the same jokes over and over again, but they're fucking really funny. So you could
Sure, you
have done
say
that.
that as well, but like I'd still like to see that again, you know. But I don't know if it would be as funny as it was
What
25 years ago. Shooting Stars.
one? Oh, shoot, that was the next one I was going to say. Shooting Stars or Bang Bang, it's Hughes and Mortimer.
Did Police Squad run out of jokes, or did they just channel them into the Naked Gun series, and or were the Naked Gun series, did they quickly run out of jokes because it was the same sort of thing?
I think probably when they did Naked Gun, I think it was like they've done a feature length, and there's nothing that you're going to see in any of the subsequent TV shows that you've already seen either in the previous TV shows or these three films that we've made. But they could have done it. They're only short, weren't they? They're only fucking 20 minutes long, I'm sure. Like 20 minutes of nonsense, almost perfect nonsense as well.
I was just thinking there, John, as well. You were talking about a program. I can't remember what one it was, because I was only half listening. But you were saying that it was a bit shit. And it was like there was a writer's strike years ago in America. And programs went a bit shit for a while because
Aye.
the writers went on strike. And I don't know, some scabs or that must have wrote some episodes or whatever. And there was a strike.
They brought in poets that didn't rhyme to do the to finish off the seasons like
That makes
that.
sense.
Aye. Because they were like, I can help if we get the proper poets in, folk are gonna have scripts that rhyme. They didn't want that, it's gonna turn into musical. So they brought the other ones in. Right, Fattest Prickus asks, true or false, Todd Cantwell.
True.
True.
Yeah, go with that. Okay, decided.
Did they not tell us the answer?
No, it's just
He's
a
looking for
question.
answer.
Only the question, so it is true, Alex. You're right. Ian T said, which ice lolly stroke ice cream is the biggest disappointment? For me, it's mint choc chip ice cream. Generally bland, not minty. Probably the worst is Corolla's, pretty pasty. And by disappointment, it means offers much promise but doesn't deliver. If you weren't sure what disappointment meant.
Just for clarification, just
Just to
for
clarify.
anybody that's listening, that doesn't care what disappointment means.
Correct.
So ice
I
cream of
or ice lolly.
ice lolly, right? So a flavour of ice cream.
That be controversial because I'm being controversial because I actually quite enjoy it, but it doesn't really like Neapolitan ice cream. Like, you know, it's got the three colours. Like, that's got some happy memories for me as a bairn. But actually, when I think about it, like, it's just like three of the blandest bits of ice cream, like three
Yeah,
bland ice cream flavours.
the flavour on it, just coloured. It's like three colours of vanilla.
Yeah.
That didn't even taste that vanilla-y. You know, you get good vanilla that's got like proper, even the wee black bits in it sometimes. Can the vanilla, the pod. I quite like, right, if I go into a decent ice cream shop and you see like a coconut ice cream or something, you go, get that bash because I like a bit of coconut. But then you can't really taste the coconut. You know what I
Aye.
mean? It's like it's that disappoints me. That's disappointed me on a number of occasions.
Think the thing about coconut, I agree, because anything that's got coconut in it, I'm just immediately drawn to it. But I think coconut itself is almost quite a bland flavour. So when you taste it, I think it's like kind of chemically
It's
enhanced.
coconut powerful enough, I agree. I think that's what it is. So I want to steer clear of that. You sometimes see Bounty ice cream or just coconut flavour, and you think, oh, get a lot, I like one of them. And then you're just thinking, you're just tasting the chocolate or the Bounty one and not the coconut. And Viennetta, mind that used to be that in our day when we were young, a special treat. You get a
Aye.
Viennetta or a mint Viennetta. That's just quite shite.
Yeah, the mint one in particular is because I like a mint choc chip ice cream if it's done nice, but you're right, if you get a bland one, it is pretty disappointing. But a nice one's good. Viennetta mint is massively disappointing. That's a great shout.
Did you pick one?
Nah, I was trying to think. Like I don't eat loads of ice cream. Like I could kind of take or leave it. I quite like sorbets. Do you know, like, there's a couple of niche ice cream shops around us, one called Scoops, and we'll go in, like, the girls like it, so we'll go in, and sometimes I'll get the sorbet. That can be disappointing, because normally sorbet's quite tangy. Do you know, like, you get, like, a raspberry one or a lemon one,
Yeah,
and if
I'm
it's,
Raven down in Lucas.
oh, do you? Well, maybe
Which
if
would
I'm
be
going
up
to
your
try that,
street.
aye.
Right.
It's not even the same town.
It's not even a street.
Big
Near
street, aye.
Lucas.
I'll try that. There's a nice a new ice cream shop in Anstruther as well. They I've not had a flavour for there yet. It's disappointing. I try to think if like ice lollies. I think generally ice lollies are disappointing though. Like unless it's like a proper nice day and you have one. There's loads of disappointing ice lollies that you think like the Oreo ones. Thinking if you had them, the Oreo cones, right? Wouldn't have them. That'll be my answer. Right, one last question because we're out of time. And it's the last question of the night, so we might as well cover it. It's from Ian again, and the topic is Encyclopedia Shortmangerous, which we probably still need to get into writing. Is there a term to describe forgetting the thrust of an argument or the question asked while delivering a response?
Go and read that for me again. Is there a term for?
Fooling nobody for that. Fooling nobody. That almost feels like the term should be a short banger, eh? Like, because you kind of get off on a tangent and you forget where you fucking started from. So I don't care if we just announced that as a term for that particular event.
The short banger.
A short that is when you've had I've had a short banger. Forgotten what you were talking about. So
does it have to be one word? Do you have to say it like in full without any sort of like break? Is it short banger rather than short banger?
Aye, yeah. I've had a short banger.
Because a short banger is the opposite of your panhandle.
Exactly. What's what were we talking about? Yeah, I've had a complete short banger. I think that's fine. That can go in the lexicon.
We were talking about this recently, weren't we? About trying to like inject a word into like common usage. If we could make it short banger, that would be amazing.
There's a. An Xbox game that's come out called Headbangers, and I was like, "Oh, fucking close, close!" They've obviously Americanized it. They've seen the name, and then I nicked it. But anyway, we'll get after them for royalties. Right, that's us out of time. Thanks for your questions, folks, and keep them coming. If you don't subscribe already, go and subscribe. It's fucking well worth it, and we'll see you next time. Well, they trailed me down when I broke free. I drank all the whiskey in Tennessee.